mind can perform the device's performance. So this type of functional ability or functional excellence of the mind at par when compared to that of the devices that have been the products of the mind. So it creates an equilibrium like E is equal to MC square, the producer is equal to the product. Both the producer as well as the product, they have equivalence and hypervalence. Even we can say they have hypervalence. The more the mind, it can detect about new thing. For example, I can travel in space, in transportation, space exploration, television, telephoning and communication networks, whatever we have invented. I want to conclude, I want to say that the mind has not only the ability to make things which can do, it is having also the ability to do. So it is having two dimensions. One is endotechnical, second is exotechnical. Making things which can do is known as exotechnical services. We themselves, we make ourselves to be capable to do. If we do, that is endotechnical. If we make things which can do, they are exotechnical. This is that type of cognotechnology we are going to teach here today. So cognotechnology is not like that at all. And the fifth thing is inverse, I have already told. Instead of understanding about the world and other things, the mind thinking about the soul and the Brahman or reality and going for liberation, emancipation, that is known as inverse model of mind. So mind has inner model, which is very abundantly present. We are having also inhibitive people. Thousands of people are working in offices and they are good users of the utility members of the devices. And there are few people who can invent. There are very few people. So it is a division. One is innate, more than that is inhibitive, more than that is inventive, more than that is innate, more than that is invert. This is the type of cognotechnology which is not there. I want to boast the glorious tradition of our land. It is a new type of dimension in the global society. With this ideology, we are going to get the things. And there are two questions, which is avyapti and vyapti. What is avyapti and avyapti and ativyapti? That is non-pervasiveness and over-pervasiveness in logics. Somebody asked a question. If you are saying that this mantra, dhyana, everything will lead us to science, then why most of the people, what is ativyapti? Most of the scientists are not, Indians are not masters of meditation. That is ativyapti. None of the Indians are scientists. None of the meditators are scientists. That is avyapti. None of the scientists are people who are in meditation and spiritual exercises. If spiritual exercises can give you clarity in science, then there are two problems, logical fallacies. One is, most of the scientists are non-practitioners of these exercises. Most of these practitioners of these things, they are non-scientists. It is known as non-pervasiveness and over-pervasiveness in logics. Then we answer this question very clearly. Scientists, they are getting the benefit because they are having some similar structures. Similarity, continuity and maturity. If Albert Einstein and Isaac Newton, Dalton, Niels Bohr and various other scientists, they have achieved something else, that may be due to three reasons. One is similarity. Even though they have not practiced these things, they would have similarly contributed something which is replaceable or substitutable. That is similarity. Second thing is continuity. Already they should have done something and it is continuing in this process. Maturity. Already they should have done and continued, and this birth they are maturing into getting those benefits. So without having that similarity, continuity and maturity, they should not got that. In also divine worship, I told about God's worship need not be worship like this. There is sacred worship, secret worship, system worship, simple worship, similar worship, later worship, associate worship, innumerable worships are there. Those who are not thinking about God and those who are against God, well, after telling something about God, abusing about God, they will say, oh God, please forgive me inside. That is secret worship. Sacred worship is very much austere, principled, everything, etc. Sacred worship. Systemic worship is living a life without harming others. That is known as system worship. Similar worship is, even though a person is not loving God or worshipping, they are caring for the society. They are caring for the diseased. They are caring for the downtrodden. They are loving nature. So loving God in a different form of the downtrodden people, elite people, loving God in the form of knowledge, loving God in the form of mercy and nature, that is similar worship. So they should have got some secret worship or sacred worship or system worship or similar worship or later worship. When the youth and the youth cholesterol that melts away, naturally there will be some insecurity and the only person available for solace is God. So any person at the age of 60 or 65, whenever a person is growing old, naturally we can predict that he will be God binded, or whenever a person is God binded, we can clearly predict that he is getting old mentally or physically. And associate worship, the persons will not worship, but their wife, children, the family people, they will do additional penance for this person's longevity and prosperity. Even if he would have given the opportunity, he would not have done so. So most of the things are, even for the most, the communists, atheists, rationalists and various other members of the society. That's what I told in a story, a person in atheist climbed a hill and he was about to fall. And lot of the other people who have gone for the picnic with him, they just instigated him to pray for God for mercy or pray for help. He did not do at all. At last by his own personal strain and effort he climbed and he was saved by himself. And at last he felt, oh thank God I did not pray for you. So like that, this type of worships are there. So why scientists, in spite of their non-practice in meditation and other exercises, how they succeeded? Because of the similar forms of worship or later forms of worship or associate forms of worship, they have understood. And why these people, those who are having this meditation and other exercises, why these people they have not succeeded? Why they have succeeded, I have answered. Similarity, continuity, maturity. Why these people they have not succeeded? Because of lack of desire, depth and diligence. They should have some desire. Even though if you do meditation, for example, if you plow your land, it does not mean that coconut or mango will grow by itself. You have to cultivate the seeds. You are having meditation. You are having a provision for understanding. But you did not think about the world. You did not think about atom. You did not think about life. So desire was not there. Lot of people are thinking about the world and other things, but the depth was not there. That craving was not there. Lot of people are thinking and thinking, but they don't do it in practice. Lot of people are speaking and thinking, but not doing practice, diligence. So continuity, maturity, as well as similarity, that has created success in the Western world where these sciences are not available, cognitive technology, in spite of availability of millions of treatises, as well as traditions and lineages of spiritual good dynasties, still these people they have not succeeded because lack of proper design, lack of proper determination and diligence. So if there is a bridge between the desire, diligence, as well as the determination of a person, with the prescribed exercises, we are going to create a de novo model. That de novo model is going to be a very great, wonderful thing, which is going to create that vision. So next time we are going to discuss with the calmness exercise and various other issues. Now, coming into a very small conclusive session, you know that bio, nano, info fields, they are mingling between each other. Each and everything I have already told, this is Chaitanya Jata, Chaitanya Ajata, and Chaitanya Swaprabhuti. Chaitanya Swapravritti, Chaitanya Jada Pravritti, Chaitanya Ajada Pravritti. So there is a natural combination between this convergence even at the time of creation. Whenever there is a temptation to know about the self-analysis or self-executive replacement or self-executive representation, along with the representation in life primeval units and matter primeval units, it is there in the structure of the creation or structure of knowledge itself. It has been realized very later. Now recently we have understood, but the creation started wherever we have entered in starting thinking about the convergence. What is the world knowledge system of our country that started with only NBIC convergence? Bhokta bhogyam preritarancha matva yushta tatastena mritatpameti bhokta bhogya prerita. Prerita, information technology. Bhogya, all other material devices, that is nanotechnology. Bhokta is the chaitanya, that is the life. Life for experiencing things. So that is known as biotechnology. So bhokta, bhogya and prerita is information, nano and bio. So the whole system of creation itself has started like that. In applications you may be knowing as you are reading the same syllabus. And also I want to say something. We want to have a team of people. For example, if biotechnology that demands use of nanoparticles,